class. Today I am going to deliver lecture on the summary trial, which is the provision mentioned in the CRPC, that is on chapter 21 from section 262 to 265. Let's start the summary trial. There is no official definition for the word trial. It may also refer to as the hearing of the statements and the presentations of the objects, etc. Okay. The aims and objects of the summary trials is that it is a sort of a trial where issues are settled fast, the trial process is streamlined and proceedings are quickly documented. इसका मतलब ये है कि summary trial इसलिए लाया गया था क्योंकि ये छोटे छोटे cases पर बहुत ज़्यादा focus करता है. जैसे कि अब हम पढ़ेंगे, जैसे those trials of a minor offences, summons और warrant trials are used for more complex cases since there is a massive and increasing backlog of cases in the court system. The main objective of the summary trial is to expedite the resolutions of the cases. Now, who are competent magistrate to try summary trials? Chief Judicial Magistrate as per your section 260 clause 1A. Metropolitan Magistrate as per your section 260 clause 1B. Even Judicial Magistrate first class can try summarily case, but here High Court have to give sanction to the Judicial Magistrate first class as per your section 260 clause 1C. Even second class Judicial Magistrate can try summarily trial as per your section 261. Now, cases that can be tried summarily. इसका मतलब ये है कि कौन कौन से offences यहाँ पे try होना चाहिए. Like, offences that are not punishable by death, life imprisonment or a sentence of more than 2 years in jail. These are the offences are not tried in the summary trial. Even if the value of the stolen property is less than 2000 rupees, the theft punishable under section 379, 380, 381 of the IPC, these are the offences which can be tried like a summary trial. Now, what are the procedure? We can go as per the section 262. It describes the process for the summary trials. In these cases, the same methodology that is applied in summon cases must be applied. However, in summary trials, if the defendant is found guilty in accordance with the chapter, no sentence longer than 3 months. So here we must know that summary trial mein jabhi bhi punishment diya jata hai, to 3 mahine se jyada usme nahi diya jata hai. Here is a brief summary for how a summon case proceeds. Filing a formal complaint, filing a FIR is the first step in criminal procedure. Now, judgment. It is mentioned under section 264, the magistrate must record the main points of the evidence before making a decision in summary trial. If accused does not enter a guilt, it means that accused does not plead guilt. 265 gives the High Court the power to appoint any magistrate or representative designated by the Chief Judicial Magistrate to conduct a summary trial or create a record, issue a verdict. Now, what are the conclusion? Let's do the conclusion now. As all we know that IPC is a substantive side of criminal proceeding, criminal offences, while the CRPC, it deals with the procedure side. Ensuring that a citizen receive a fair and impartial trial is the fundamental objective of any criminal system. So, it is well known that there are a disproportionately large number of cases pending in India and that the judiciary is overburdened. So, trials are laborious, time consuming process that takes years to finish. Because of this, it has been separated into three categories according to how serious the offense is, where citizens have the opportunity to pursue justice in even the most minor circumstances through the summary trials. By administrating justice without piling too many minor infractions for the higher court, it strikes a balance. Thank you, class.